Hi, this is Chiquita Washington, and this is my overview of Dr. Pepper Snapple Group.
I drink Dr. Pepper, don't you see? 'Cause it's the perfect taste for me. That original taste, you know, is making peppers everywhere I go. There's potent peppers, toting peppers, cooking peppers, good-looking peppers. Wouldn't you like to be a pepper too? Us peppers are an interesting breed. An original taste is what we need. Ask any pepper and he'll say,
only Dr. Pepper tastes that way.
There's carrion peppers, marrying peppers, diet peppers, quiet peppers. Wouldn't you like to be a pepper too? There's saluting peppers, tooting peppers.
Mama the pepper man.
Wouldn't you like to be a pepper too? Be a pepper, dream Dr. Pepper.
Dr. Pepper was first created at Morosini's Old Corner Drug Store in Waco, Texas in 1885, making it the oldest soft drink in the United States. It was first created by Charles Alderton, a pharmacist, when he mixed several fruit-flavored carbonated beverages. After creating a flavor he liked, his boss taste tested it and decided to serve it at their soda fountain. Popularity soon grew, and other soda fountain operators wanted to sell it as well, so Morrison began producing a syrup for the drink. Robert Lansdenby, a beverage chemist and proprietor of the Circle Ginger Ale Company, tasted the drink and offered to produce the syrup at his bottling plant. In 1904, Lansdenby introduced Dr. Pepper at the World's Fair, giving 20 million people a chance to taste it. In 1923, the growing company moved from Waco to Dallas. In 1986, Dr. Pepper Company merged with the 7-Up Company. And in 1995, Cadbury Schweppes acquired Dr. Pepper 7-Up Incorporated. Here's a picture of where it all started, Morosini Corner Drug Store. Dr. Pepper Snapple Group Incorporated emerged into a major beverage company with an integrated business model including brand ownership, bottling, and distribution of non-alcoholic beverages in the U.S., Canada, and Mexico. The company's portfolio includes dozens of brands of flavored carbonated soft drinks and non-carbonated beverages like mixers, juice drinks, and ready-to-drink teas and juices. Since the spinoff of Cadbury in May 2008, the company has established itself as one of the top non-cola carbonated soft drinks companies in the U.S., and it has maintained the number 3 spot in the broader beverage industry in North America. Dr. Pepper Snapple Group competes with the U.S. beverage manufacturer and bottling industry. The industry is made up of about 3,000 companies, including manufacturers, bottlers, and distributors of non-alcoholic beverages. Despite the vast majority of companies in the industry, revenues are highly concentrated. Over 90% of its combined $70 billion annual revenues are generated by the three largest companies, Coca-Cola, Pepsi Company, and Dr. Pepper Snapple and their subsidiaries. The two major players of the industry, the Coca-Cola Company and the Pepsi Company. These companies have a presence in more than 200 countries and own strong brands that enjoy huge popularity around the world. Dr. Pepper consumers are included in a market of about 314,858,000 total adults, according to the last 2014 count by the U.S. Census. And Dr. Pepper drinkers represent about 16.9% of the total market share. The beverage manufacturer and bottling industry is greatly influenced by economic stability, consumer tastes and preferences, and commodities prices. They are all of great importance to beverage company managers who develop and implement strategies to respond to changes in the industry. However, economic stability is the most significant factor influencing food and beverage companies. Since carbonated soft drinks are discretionary items, sales are considerably impacted by weakness in the economy. Between 2008 and 2010, the economy was a major problem facing beverage companies like Dr. Pepper Snapple, Coke, and Pepsi. I am now going to analyze the opportunities and threats of Dr. Pepper Snapple Group. First, I'm going to discuss the opportunities. Dr. Pepper has the opportunity to expand itself into international markets. Currently, Dr. Pepper Sample effectively draws no significant portion of revenue from outside North America, comparing the company to Coca-Cola, which operates in over 200 countries and derives approximately 76% of revenues outside of North America. Dr. Pepper Sample could see a large increase in revenues if it decided to expand internationally. There is also room for opportunities with implementing new product launches and line extensions. Dr. Pepper Sample sees the best opportunity for growth through line extensions, especially with opportunities in high growth and high margin categories, including ready-to-drink beverages. Next, I am going to discuss the threats and risks they face. They have high exposure to a declining soda market as more consumers are trying to live a healthier lifestyle, here is trying to stay away from carbonated beverages. Dr. Pepper Sample also face impediments to international growth, and they have a high dependence on third-party growth. Dr. Pepper Sample Group is organized into three categories. They are packaged beverages segment, beverage concentrate segment, and Latin America beverages segment. The packaged beverages segment derives revenues from the sale of finished beverages, including the sale of certain third-party brands in the United States and Canada. The segment contributed 72% of the company's 2013 revenues and 38% of its total segment's operating profits. The beverage concentrate segment is the most profitable segment. It accounted for 20% of the 2013 revenues and a significant 57% of the total segment operating profits. This segment derives revenues from the sale of branded concentrates and certs. The Latin America beverages segment sells concentrates, certs, and finished beverages in the Mexico, Caribbean, and other international markets. The segment contributes 8% of the revenues and 4% of the total segment operating profits. Recently, the company has been targeting Hispanics and millennials in its advertising campaigns. According to the U.S. Census Bureau, Hispanics will account for 19% of the U.S. population by year 2020. Dr. Pepper Snapple's business is growing rapidly in Latin America with successful brands like Pentafil. The company is now planning to bring Pentafil, a sparkling mineral water brand, to the Hispanic community in the United States. The millennial demographic represents the generation of people who were born between 1981 and 1996. Nielsen, a global information and measurement company, estimates that this highly influential group represents 24% of the U.S. population. Companies catering to this young, tax-savvy group with their brands, packaging, and campaigns include Dr. Pepper Sample and its peers such as Coca-Cola and Pepsi companies. Dr. Pepper Sample offers more than 50 brands, including 6 of the top 10 non-cola soft drinks. Some of the most popular include, of course, Dr. Pepper, Snapple, A&W, Mott, Canada Dry, Sundrop, Hawaiian Punch, and 7-Up. Dr. Pepper Sample Group beverages reach the consumers through the company's own distribution network, third-party distributors, and direct delivery to customers' warehouses. In 2013, the company manufactured and distributed about 49% of the product volume sold in the United States. In addition to manufacturing finished beverages at company-owned facilities, Dr. Pepper Snapple sells its concentrates to third-party bottlers who combine them with carbonated water, sweeteners, and other ingredients, and sell the finished beverage to retailers. Dr. Pepper is in the process of expanding its distribution network inside and outside of the U.S. In March 2013, Dr. Pepper Snapple acquired certain assets of Dr. Pepper 7-Up Bottling Company of the West, which is based in Nevada. The acquisition strengthened the company's distribution rights in the United States, primarily in parts of Northern and Western California and Idaho. Dr. Pepper Snapple's November 2014 acquisition of Davis Beverage Group and Davis Bottling Company nearly doubled its distribution in Pennsylvania. This deal gives the company glass packets, manufacturing capabilities, and distribution control of many brands such as 7-Up, Snapple, A&W, Canada Dry, and Sunkist in the acquired region. Outside of the U.S., in Mexico, Dr. Pepper Snapple has a presence in carbonated mineral water, flavored carbonated soft drinks, bottled water, and vegetable juice under key brand names such as Pentafil, Squirt, Aquafil, Crush, and Clamato. Dr. Pepper Snapple Mexico business sells its products through its own distribution operations and third-party bottlers. In trying to expand its geographical reach, In 2013, Dr. Pepper Snapple reacquired from Mondelez International the distribution rights for Snapple and several other non-carbonated beverages brands in certain parts of Asia Pacific. The deal provided Dr. Pepper Snapple distribution rights for the Snapple brand in Australia, Malaysia, Singapore, China, Hong Kong, Japan, and South Korea. The company will also own distribution rights in Australia for Mott, Mr. and Mrs. T, Clamato, Mystic, Holland House, and Yoohoo. Recently, consumers have started to see higher pricing on carbonated beverages. The beverage industry remains pressured by weak demand for carbonated soft drinks. Therefore, Dr. Pepper Snapple, as well as its competitors, are increasing the price of their carbonated drinks to try to offset the drop in demand. Consumers are also paying higher prices for soda thanks to new types of product packages, such as 8-ounce cans versus the standard 12-ounce size. Dr. Pepper Snapple has had plenty of memorable campaigns over the years. Three of the most memorable are probably the Be a Pamper campaign, Dr. Pepper 10, and One of a Kind. The Be a Pepper campaign had everyone from Michael Jackson to NBA stars claiming they were a pepper. Probably the boldest campaign of them all is the Dr. Pepper 10 campaign. Dr. Pepper 10 is a low-calorie product with the same flavor as Dr. Pepper. The company targeted young men as the consumers for this product and brought out a bold campaign with the It's Not for Women tagline. The company's rationale behind this campaign was that young men would like a low-calorie option without the diet imagery. The campaign did face a lot of criticism from female consumers. Another memorable one is the One of a Kind commercial. In that campaign, Dr. Pepper has taken a no-competition position, saying that they are number one in its own category, and their aim is to reposition their consumers to promoting the fact that they are one of a kind.
Whether I'm right or whether I'm wrong, gotta be me. I want to live, not merely survive, and I won't give up on this dream of life that keeps me alive.
This year, Dr. Pepper Snapple Group has plans to trim $30 million from its marketing budget. According to Dr. Pepper Snapple's annual report, it spent $486 million on advertising and marketing in 2013, and $190 million on measured media last year, according to Kantar Media. That's down significantly from $216 million in 2010. Even though Dr. Pepper Snapple is cutting its marketing budget, they still needed an aggressive presence in the market, so they developed a strategy to get them right on track. Dr. Pepper Snapple Group has identified three main focus points that they are going to focus on for their promotion and marketing strategy. They decided to identify and focus on key brands that they believe have the greatest potential for profitable sales and growth, and invest most heavily in those brand extensions to take advantage of evolving consumer trends, improving distribution, and increasing promotional effectiveness. They also want to increase their presence in high-margin channels and packages. They are focused on improving their product presence in high-margin channels, such as convenience stores, vending machines, and small independent retail outlets, through increased selling activity and investments in coolers and other cold drink equipment. Last but not least, they are focused on opportunities in high-growth and high-margin categories that are emerging, such as ready-to-drink tea, energy drinks, and other functional beverages. Dr. Pepper Snapple is trying to better position themselves with their competitors and narrow the gap. Although all three companies are leading manufacturers of carbonated and non-carbonated drinks, Dr. Pepper Snapple has had difficulty getting out of that third spot. All three companies sell a wide range of different products, As I mentioned earlier, Dr. Pepper Snapple is home to over 50 different products, but Coke owns and licenses nearly 500 other brands, including diet and light beverages, enhanced waters, juice drinks, teas, coffee, sports, and energy drinks. According to analysts, part of the reason that Dr. Pepper Snapple is so much smaller can be attributed to the spinoff of Dr. Pepper Snapple from Cadbury in 2008. Taking advantage of the company's position post-spinoff, Coke and Pepsi had a significant head start on acquiring healthier juices, teas, and enhanced waters. Analysts suggest that Dr. Pepper Snapple had insufficient resources at the time to keep up with competing acquisitions. Besides problems gaining overall market share in the U.S., Dr. Pepper Snapple has also had difficulty competing internationally. The company generates about 89% of its revenues in the U.S. market, 80% of which comes from carbonated soft drinks. In comparison, Coke collects about 74% of its sales outside of North America, and Pepsi generates over 40% of its sales internationally. Hopefully, with Dr. Pepper Snapple's new marketing strategy, they can close the gap a little sooner than later. And that concludes my overview of Dr. Pepper Snapple Group.
The following are the sources that were used for my research.